I'd like to introduce myself, and then I'm also going to turn the microphone over to Carol and DiDomenico. My name is Harriet Weiss, and I'm the president of the Healthcare Auxiliary. We're the group that is, with help from others, putting on the 11th annual Cancer Survivor Celebration. I would like to, before I turn things over to Carolyn, I'd like to just say thank you to some of our very, very generous sponsors. They are, and I would also call your attention to the really great banner that's over there against the wall, because I'm not even going to try to list all the names, but these are some of our major sponsors: Founders Insurance, Smilo Cancer Center, Sharon Hospital, Gear Physical Therapy, Salisbury Breads, and Hathaway Young Catering. We would like to give special thanks also to Carolyn, Caroline Birchfield, and I don't know whether she's here or not because I have a little something for her. But
I don't know what we would have done without her, so just a little something for you.
You were
amazing.
I know you.
Harriet, she was a garden.
And I'd also like to give a special thanks to a couple of people. The beautiful marigolds that you see on your tables are all grown by Noreen Driscoll Breslauer and Sweet Haven Farm. They are called Heroes, and how very apropos for tonight. And Noreen has been doing this growing and tending and caring for these little babies, and I think the fact that we're a couple of weeks later with this event really got to give you all a really beautiful show of how gorgeous they are. One other little special thank you, and I don't know if I see him in the room or not, but Tim Kay, I don't know if he's here. He helped make our first ever sandwich boards, which we never had before, so thanks to Tim. Thanks for being so understanding as we tried to get our posters up. Appreciate it. Carolyn, I think I'm going to turn it over to you.
Okay. Thank you, Harriet. As we said before, I am Carolyn DiDomenico, and I am a 13-year survivor. Thank you. I'll tell you, when it happened, I wasn't happy. My doctor said it's going to be a bump in the road. And he was right. So I thank all my wonderful physicians and nurses, but mainly I thank my husband, Richard, who's tending bar down there, because today is a celebration not only for survivors, but for our support. All the people that have stood by us and who have helped us get through this wonderful process of cancer treatment. I know, I went the whole nine yards. I had my surgery, I had chemotherapy, I had radiation, I had every single side effect known to man during my treatment. And, you know, they tell you when you have a baby, oh, you forget, and then you go and have another one. Well, I pretty much forgot about the cancer, but I hope to God I never have to do it again, you know, that it was really awful, awful thing. But a memory now, a real memory. And I have become a member of the Healthcare Auxiliary, and this is one of the auxiliary's events that really helps support cancer patients and the people who support those patients. So we welcome you. We welcome you one and all, and wish you all well. I also heard when I was diagnosed, they said that from the very minute you are diagnosed, you become a survivor. So if I had a glass right now, I'd raise my glass to you all and say congratulations, one and all. And we're going to have a really good time and have a great program for you tonight. My next job is to introduce our MC. His name is Brent Colley. He is a man of many talents, and he's originally from Reading, Connecticut, and he moved to Sharon about 13 years ago. He is a local historical buff. He knows all about the Indian pathways in Connecticut. I heard all about that. And he's also the president of the Historical Society in Sharon. He has a lovely wife, Christine, and two children, Liam and Emma, and two black labs. Okay. He is the newest, latest, first selectman of Sharon. And I'd like you all to welcome our MC for the evening, Mr. Brent Colley.
Thank you, Carolyn. It's a pleasure to be here. And to all the residents of Sharon, I will not be talking about roads or bears or blight issues tonight. Tonight is a celebration of the strength, the perseverance, the faith, the optimism, and the defiance that each and every cancer survivor here in this room possesses. And for them, I'd like to give them a round of applause. Please do. Now, I rarely read my speeches, but I have to admit that I pulled this together last night. So I will be doing a little bit of reading tonight. As I was putting this together, my six-year-old was asking me about how the Major League Baseball playoffs work. So my focus wasn't there, but I'm going to tell you the story of cancer and how it affected my life and my wife's life and everyone around us. Cancer is a vexingly heartless disease. It defies rational explanation, attacking the innocent, assaulting the good, and in so many cases, it just doesn't make sense. I mean, how does my wife, who, you know, she cares for people every single day, and she monitors every ounce of what goes in and on her body, ours too, my kids can vouch for that. But she contracts cancer and, oh, I don't know, someone like Keith Richards gets a pass from it. It doesn't make any sense. And it's destroyed so many lives. But on National Cancer Survivors Day, this isn't about that side of cancer. And neither is tonight. Tonight is a celebration of life and a celebration of all those who had the courage to take on man's greatest fear, the fear of death. That's a pretty big fear to overcome, and considering how and when it comes, because it usually arrives like an evil little package when you least expect it. That's the way it did for us. And as a physician's assistant, Christine knew far too much and had access to far too much information, and that significantly amped the fear factor within her. I think, in thinking back about it, as a protection mechanism, my brain has blocked out a lot of the specifics of that time period. But it was dark, it was pitch black. And I wasn't even the one that had cancer. But what I do remember is a story that in a lot of ways changed my life and renewed my faith. My family's business had clients across the nation. And to service these accounts, they partnered with similar countries across the nation. And that was good for business and it was good for them. They met a lot of great people. Two of these people lived in the Bible Belt. And whenever times got rough for our family or theirs, the requests went out for prayers. Around the time Christine was diagnosed with cancer, my mother had asked the Venerables to pray for my brother's wife, Lindsay. However, each time Debbie sat down to pray for Lindsay, Christine's name popped into her head. They had never met us and didn't even know we existed, but day after day, Debbie sat down to pray for Lindsay, and the result was, no, you need to pray for Christine. So finally, Debbie decided enough was enough, and she asked my mom, who is Christine? My mom explained that she was my wife and had just been diagnosed with cancer. And then they sat there on the phone in silence for a long, long time. It makes you wonder, spiritual guidance or random coincidence, but we locked into spiritual guidance and the power of prayer. And we still can't get over how many people also bought into that and helped us in that effort. That's what Christine remembers the most. How many people that let her know that they were praying for her. Another important part about cancer is that it forces you to buy into a lot of things that are not easy to buy into, but you have no choice. You're forced to change. And if you buy in, change, and survive, that evil little surprise package becomes a gift. You learn the importance of friends and family, the importance of embracing the present. When times were, you know, really deep and dark for me, I'd always ask myself, but what's good about right now? And it could have been the song on the radio, it could have been the sun on my face, but that's what I focused on, and that's how I got through it. You learn not to care about what other people think. You learn to say no to things that you really don't want to do, to take risks, to live for today, and do what you want to do. Ultimately, you learn what matters and what doesn't. You gain strength, courage, confidence, and as you exit the darkness of cancer, you grow as a human being. You realize that you can't beat cancer alone. You need help, and you appreciate every ounce of help you received, and you want to pay it back. That's why we're here tonight. Cancer forced us to buy into a lot of things that were not easy, but we bought in, and we did it, and we're here. Tonight we're here to celebrate the strength, the perseverance, the faith, the optimism, and the defiance that each and every cancer survivor here in this room possesses. So let's begin. We have a terrific lineup today of music and food and company, and I'm so happy to be here and share my story with you. So thank you for inviting me. It's tough to share those things because you get dragged back into a dark place, and it's rough. But one of the men that helped me so many times, not even knowing it really, was Father Fader, because he's the priest of our church. And somehow, some way, every Sunday that we went, you tapped into something we were feeling, and we went home feeling better. So, So it's a real honor to introduce you tonight for the invocation, and thank you.
Put me in front of a microphone, and that's dangerous. We'll start with a story before I do the invocation. An old farmer with his overalls walked down to his mailbox, and he began to hammer a sign onto the mailbox that said, "Puppies for sale." And before he finished hammering the sign on the mailbox, he felt a tug on his overalls, and he looked down, and there was a little boy looking up at him.
"I'm all right."
And the boy looked up and said, "I want to buy one of your puppies." And the farmer said, "They come from very good stock, and I don't think you have enough money." And the boy, smiling, looked up and says, "I have 39 cents. Can I see the puppies?" So the farmer said, "Sure." So he yells out and whistles, "Dolly!" And Dolly comes out of her doghouse, followed by four beautiful puppies. They all sauntered down the hill by the chain link fence, and they looked through the fence, and the boy immediately fell in love with the puppies. Then he noticed that in the doghouse there was still movement, and this little puppy made it out of the doghouse and kind of rolled a little bit and fell a little bit down the hill towards the chain link fence. And the boy immediately smiled and said, "I want that one." And the farmer looked down and says, "You know, that's the one you probably don't want. He's never going to grow up to be too much. He has a leg that is never going to heal. And you probably are never going to run and play with him." And the boy kind of looked at the farmer and says, "He's exactly what I need." And at that point, he reached down and he began to roll up one of his pants legs, and it revealed a special shoe and two steel braces that went up to his hip. And he said, "I think I will understand what he's going through." So the farmer said, If you want him, you can have him. And the boy says, how much is he going to cost? And the farmer said, there's no price for love. No price for love. I think we're here tonight to share that love with each other. Because without that love and without that care and without that compassion, without that understanding, you can't make it. You can't make it. Now, I have cancer, but it's skin cancer that comes on and off of my face and nothing serious. But I did survive the death of my wife almost 33 years ago. And there's something about pain and suffering, something about sorrow. There's something that makes us stronger, not weaker. Something that builds us up inside and gives us the courage and strength to go on. So let me pray. I wrote out a prayer for tonight. Dear God, we gather this afternoon as survivors. Life has not been easy for us, and at times the proverbial deck of cards seemed to have been stacked against us. But we are present to rejoice and to celebrate life. We have every reason to be angry and bitter about the cards that dealt us, but we are not. No longer asking the question, why me, but affirming, why not me, dear God? Dear God, you are no stranger to suffering and pain yourself, but you put forth before us an example of perseverance, one we are asked to follow. We thank you, God, for the wonderful angels you have sent into our lives. Doctors, nurses, aides, friends, and family that have loved and supported us, especially in the darkest hours of our day. We are here today as a testament that we have not given up hope. We pray that you will continue to give us the courage to support each other and to come to realize that life, in the end, is not all about me. When I think only about me, my pain closes in on me. But when open, you can get to think about our pain as a collective group. And that's what we are doing here tonight. Not concentrating on my pain, but the pain that is shared by everyone that is here in this room tonight. But you do not stop there, dear God. But in time to think about the entire pain of humanity, to think about the pain that the world suffers, the pain of the parents that lost children at Sandy Hook, the pain of the violence that is around the world are today. It is a great pain to bear. But we are up for it, dear God. It seems there is so much around us, and unless we are taught to support each other, as you do, our pain causes us more harm than healing. But when we reach out to each other, when we share each other's pain, when we tell each other's stories, when we embrace each other with love, we are given the courage and strength of God. Bless us, dear Lord, as we gather before you, knowing you are with us in our joy and in the dark valleys we often have to face. In God's name we pray, amen.
Hi, good evening. My name is Harriet Weiss, and I'm the president of the Healthcare Auxiliary for the Tri-State Region, and we sometimes refer to ourselves as HCA. We have several projects that we are very proud of. This event that is happening tonight is our 11th annual Cancer Survivor Celebration, and we have lots of really great music tonight. We have Wanda Houston and Michael Berkeley, we have Trish Walsh, we have Dave Vandebogart and Pat Thorney, and we're going to really have just a really good night of music and fun, and we've got some great food and beverages. Almost everything has been donated, and We're just really, really, really happy for the support that we've gotten from the community.
Okay.
We do some other things during the year. We have a very active and robust scholarship program. Right now we are giving help to 18 students. Not everyone is sort of your traditional high school graduate. Some of them are adults who are pursuing additional degrees or trying to advance themselves in some way. And everything that all of the scholarship students are pursuing some sort of healthcare related field of study. So that's sort of our niche. We've been doing that for a long, long time. We also are the people that run the Bargain Barn in Sharon, Connecticut, and the Gazebo Gift Shop in Sharon Hospital Lobby. We've been doing that for over 40 years. We also have recently been sponsoring the Safe Sitter Program, which is a certification course for babysitting. And in the late spring, we also did some work and some funding for Salisbury Central School. They did the American Red Cross babysitting, CPR, first aid certification. So we've been working with them also. And we're looking forward to a good year and hopefully support from the community and more members. We are a membership organization and we have a very affordable membership fee. It's $15 a year. And I would direct you to our website. It's www.healthcareauxiliary.org. And we look forward to new members and your thoughts and ideas on how we can give back to the community.
Okay. Is this a silent auction going on in,
it is,
in the back?
It's a raffle.
Oh, okay.
It's not, you know, you buy some raffle tickets and you put them in the pot in front of the article that you're interested in.
Okay.
So it's like that.
And the money is a fundraiser for?
The money is a fundraiser for our outreach for cancer survivorship. And I can tell you just a little bit about what we did last year with the proceeds from last year's event. We helped fund the hospice massage program. We also gave a donation to the Weekend Row survivor rowing team so that they can hopefully one of these days buy their own racing skull. We sponsored a lecture for the cancer support group at Sharon Hospital, and we had enough left over to sort of jumpstart this year's event. So we're looking forward to this next year. We have already designated some money to the Wings of Hope team that was part of the Relay for Life this past weekend. So we're starting the year off, we think, in a good way.